Vaccination is part and parcel of every person's life, usually from the day they are born up to when they become adults, depending with where you live on this planet. There are so many myths associated with vaccination, and also there are also so many practices that most parents do that are usually not necessary, if not more harmful to your baby. This video is meant to demystify those myths and tell you what you're not supposed to do once your baby receives vaccination. Vaccination does not cause autism. The paper that was responsible to publish that misinformation happened in 1997, and the doctor responsible received severe disciplinary actions. So please make sure you take your babies to get vaccinated without fear of them developing autism. Babies' immune systems are very strong. In an otherwise healthy infant, there is no way vaccination can ever overwhelm the baby's immune system. Theoretically, if let's say the immune system was constant, the vaccination that a human gets, if they are to receive all the necessary vaccination, would have only worked on less than 0.1% of the immune system. But think of this, every single day that the baby lives, there's always replacement of new cells. So with that, there is no way that vaccination can ever overwhelm the baby's immune system. And second thing is, the billions of bacteria and viruses that this baby gets exposed on daily basis from the environment, it's way, way much more, and the vaccination is literally a drop in the ocean. So just relax, take your baby to get vaccinated. When someone says they prefer getting natural immunity, what they are really saying is they prefer exposing their babies to all types of diseases and let their baby fight that disease and them getting healed, and then they get the immunity against that specific disease. But think of what really means to your baby. Let's use a simple example, maybe just rotavirus infection. Getting rotavirus vaccine means getting the little drops that you usually get at week 6 and at week 10. But imagine your baby getting rotavirus infection instead. The amount of diarrhea, the amount of vomiting, the amount of scaring, all the risk of complication, the amount of time that you will have to actually spend in hospital just because you prefer your baby getting natural immunity vis-a-vis vaccination for the immunity against a specific disease. That is very expensive for you and your baby, and actually it may even cost your baby's life or even lead to severe disability that may automatically change your baby's life. So for that reason, please remember to take your baby to get vaccinated at the right time, not a day before, not a day after, unless there's a really good reason for you not being able to take your baby to get vaccinated. And if you're not able to keep up the appointments, please remember to discuss with your healthcare provider and get the missed vaccination covered as much as you can. It is very, very rare. I know some babies may get some symptoms after they received some vaccines, but just remember that the symptoms that you're getting are actually the body's response to the vaccine, and not that the symptoms indicate now my baby has gotten that disease. We commonly see fever and rash, especially after getting the measles vaccine and also the chickenpox vaccine. But usually that fever does not last long. It's usually just 24 hours, in the first 24 hours, and the baby is okay. Or maybe the rash may be very brief, and it will not, like if it's a rash after measles or chickenpox, it will not be the typical measles or chickenpox rash. So again, all these are just responses to the vaccine that you've just given your baby. Then this one is very specific for Kenyans, that baby-friendly vaccines are actually painless. One thing that you should always know, unless a vaccine is given orally, all the other vaccines are actually injectables. And if they're injectables, it means we use needles to give the vaccines. And if we use needles, it means the skin has to be broken by this needle. Now, of course, depending on the size of the needle, may sometimes mean different intensity for pain. So just remove this notion that baby-friendly vaccines are actually painless. They are all injections. What are you not supposed to do after your baby has actually received vaccination? Number one, do not rub the site that the baby has received the injection. Most of the injections are given at the thigh. And so once you go home, do not attempt to rub. You can apply some ice or apply a cold cloth because sometimes it can really be painful. But please do not attempt to rub. I know most parents do not want their babies to actually feel pain because they think pain is the worst thing that can happen to a baby. But please do not give your baby paracetamol before you go for vaccination or after, especially in the first 6 hours after receiving the vaccination. It is wrong. Pain will not kill your baby, but you need a good response from your baby's immune system so that at the end of the day, they are able to benefit from the vaccines that they have received. Giving paracetamol may interfere with the body's immune response. Remember, if each one of us vaccinates their baby as scheduled in each government immunization plan, we are more likely to eradicate some certain type of diseases from our planet for good. And that is really the goal, because no one wants to have a neighbor who has a contagious disease, because chances are you are also going to be exposed. So vaccinating your baby is not just about you, it's about where you live and all the children in that area. Please let us be responsible enough and making sure that we go to vaccinate our babies on time and all the time. Thank you so much for taking your baby to get vaccinated.